past 30 years, we've seen a class war against poor and working people, acting as if poor and working people have no dignity, no decency, rendering their condition invisible. And we say, no, we fight back, and we fight back with imagination. We fight back with vision. We echo that last line of Percy Shelley's great pamphlet that said, the poets are the unacknowledged legislators of the world. And by poets, he didn't mean versifiers. He meant all human beings who muster the courage to use their imagination and empathy to envision an alternative world and to change the world in light of that alternative world. And that alternative world is a radically democratic world that says that there's dignity in those Sly Stone called everyday people. And when ordinary people lift their voices and actually shake the prophecies that make decisions that affect all of our lives, we don't have Wall Street oligarchs getting away with murder. We don't have corporate plutocrats getting away with murder. And by murder, I mean the metaphoric sense of murder, meaning billions and billions of dollars hemorrhaged at the top, with 1% of the population owning 40% of the wealth, but 22% of our precious children of all colors living in poverty, and 42% of our children of all colors living near poverty in the richest nation in the history of the world. That's a moral disgrace. That's an ethical obscenity. People before profits. If we decide to stand up, we decide to stand the way Sly Stone said stand. And any time ordinary people straighten their backs up, they're going somewhere, because folk can't ride your back unless it's bent. And yes, in the early 90s, we learned it from South Africa with Nelson Mandela and others. They straightened their backs up and they broke the back of an apartheid regime. And in Tunisia, in Egypt, in Northern Africa, they straightened their backs up and they broke the back of old dictatorial elites and allies of the U.S. government. In Wisconsin, you said, you know what? We gonna straighten our backs up too. We gonna come together. Working people gonna come together. Community activists gonna come together. Black people gonna come together with white, with red, with yellow. Why? Because we are one people, and we fundamentally believe in decency. It's not just a matter of politics. It's not just a matter of ideology. We want to be decent human beings and live lives of dignity, and we can do it in a democratic way if we can be honest about the mendacity and the hypocrisy of the oligarchs and the plutocrats who disproportionately rule in America and have been actually seizing so much of the democratic views in the body politic. And I say this with love. Oh yes. Oh yes, I'm a Christian. I try to love everybody. But I have some political foes that I'm ready to go battle. Oh yes, I'm ready to engage in battle. Too many precious babies out there. Too many working people pushed against the wall. Too many gay brothers and lesbian sisters spit on. Too many black folk and brown folk and red folk forgotten about. Too many Jewish brothers and sisters and Arab brothers and sisters marginalized. It's a matter of being decent. That's the legacy of Martin King and the legacy of Fannie Lou Hamer and the legacy of Abraham Joshua Heschel and the legacy of Dorothy Day. And we will never forget their struggle. The legacy of Cesar Chavez, the legacy of so many who came before. Sankofa Bird means something. We look back in order to build on the best, in order to move forward and to teach our young people that life is not a matter of just being successful and being well-adjusted to injustice and well-adapted to indifference. It's not a matter of just being stimulated and titillated. It's a matter of learning how to care and learning how to nurture and learning how to take courage. Not just making money and gaining assets to status and position. It's a matter of taking courage to have a sensitivity to the least of these. The sensitivity of those catching hell, not just here in Wisconsin, not just in California and New York, but also in Latin America, in Asia, around the world. This is a matter of the human. God bless you.